we are discussing about the respiration in organisms. Yesterday I told for you how much we will inhale and how much we will exhale. When we are inhaling, we are taking a 1000 milliliters of air, and when we are exhaling 1000 milliliters of air. In that, when we are inhaling, we are taking 210 milliliters of oxygen and the remaining gases in 790 milliliters. Okay, that is totally equal to 1000 milliliters we are taking inside. Then when we are exhaling, we are exhaling 165% of oxygen, 40% of carbon dioxide and 795% of all the remaining gases we discussed. Then the air we breathe in does not contain only oxygen. It is a mixture of a number of gases. What are those gases? What did I say those gases are? Oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, then helium, neon, krypton, argon, etc. These all gases are present in that one. Then similarly, the air we breathe out is also not only carbon dioxide. It is a mixture of all these gases. Then the quantity of gas in every single inhaling and exhaling is 1000 milliliters. Inspired and expired. Try to state the difference between inspired and expired air on the basis of experiment 5, 6, 7 and the table given above. The kind of change that we see through the experiments done so far and the table, we come to know a process that occurs beyond breathing known as respiration. In all the above experiments and whatever we are discussing, we are seeing what is inspiration, what is expiration, what is inhaling and what is exhaling we are discussing. Breathing. Now we are going to discuss about breathing in animals. How the animals respire. Respiration. In. Respiration in animals we are going to discuss now. In that, the first one, fish. We all know now the fish. How the fish respires? Fish respires through gills. Okay. Fish respires through gills. So let us talk about that. Observe fishes in aquarium. Fishes continuously open and close their mouth. Where they are getting oxygen? These fishes, from the water. Does the water contain oxygen? Yes. From the water, the fishes are getting the oxygen. So, fishes continuously open and close their mouth in water. Why do they flap on both sides? Their wings will be there, no? Always they will flap the wings on both the sides, head alternatively open and close. Why it is happening like that? Why they will open the mouth, why they will fin their wings, means if you look below the flaps, you will see a red colored part will be present. The red color part are called as the gills. These are the respiratory organs of the fish. The water that enters the mouth flows through both the gills, which are present besides, as it comes off from the flaps. The take from the mouth and send through the gills. They'll take from the mouth. Means where the respiration it is taking through gills. The gills absorb the oxygen that is dissolved in the water. This oxygen is carried to all the parts of the fish. All the different parts of the fish. Did you understand that? How the fish respires? Where the oxygen is present? The oxygen is present in the water. The fish always opens and closes its mouth. When it is opening and closing its mouth, it is taking inside the water. That water will come out through the gills. The gills are red in color. And when it is these gills, what they will do? When the water comes to its plate, it absorbs the oxygen present in the water and passes and gives to all parts of the body. Next one is frog. We know that frog is an amphibian. It can live in water, it can live on land, and it can live under the soil. Then, what are the respiratory organs of the frog? Now, for fish means we are telling that it is gills. For frog, gills. Again, then lungs. Then skin. It can respire through three parts. What are those? Gills, lungs and skin. When it is in the tadpole form, it uses its gills. When the frog is in tadpole form, it uses its gills. When the frog is on land, it uses its lungs. When it is under soil, it uses its moist skin. We have to say that the skin is moist. Frog respires through three parts. What are those three? Gills, lungs and moist skin. So that's why we are telling frog is an amphibian. It can live in the water, on land and under the soil. When it is in the tadpole form, you know that how the tadpole form is, the head part will be there, here the tail part will be present. This is the tadpole form of the frog. So when it is in this form, it uses its gills. When it is adult, then it uses its lungs on land. When it is under the soil, it uses its moist skin. So let us see here. What about the frog? What we can see here, in class 6 we have studied that frog is able to stay on land, in water and even underground. How does it manage to do so? To breathe on land, it has lungs. While it goes deep underground and sleep twice every year, it how many times in a year? 2 times. In a year, 2 times it will go and sleep under the soil, it seems. So to breathe on land, it uses its lungs. While it goes deep underground and sleep twice every year, its moist skin takes over the function of its lungs. In a baby frog or in the form of a tadpole, what it will do? Their special organs like that of fish, those are called as gills. And these gills help them to breathe in water by taking in the air dissolved in water. Got the point? Then tadpoles of the frog live only in water, but the frog lives either on land or in the water. Sometimes you may see frogs under the soil also. So in all the three places they can survive. So what is the respiratory organ of a tadpole means? Gills. What is the respiratory organ of the tadpole means? Gills. What is the respiratory organ of adult frog means? Lungs. What is the respiratory organ of the frog when it is under the soil? Okay, that means it's a moist skin. See the blank and try to, if it is in the form, this question always repeats in the exam. Then you will explain all the three parts and about the frog you will. If not, if they are asking in the form of blank means, you are going to explain in this manner. Got the point? The next one, about cockroach. What are the respiratory organs of a cockroach? Cockroach, what it will use? It uses spiracles. Okay, now see here. A cockroach has small openings on the sides of its body. Small openings will be present on the side. Other insects have similar opening. Other insects like grasshopper or some other insects also will have in the same way. On the underside of the cockroach, down part of the cockroach, in each segment there are small holes which are connected through respiratory tube. Okay, in a network. These help the cockroach to breathe. These holes are called as, what are those holes present near the respiratory tube means? They are called as the spiracles. The network of respiratory tube, what is that network where this respiratory tube is present? That is called as a trachea. What do you say it as a trachea? Okay, and trachea take air from the spiracles, circulate it throughout the body, collect it back and send it out through these spiracles. Once again, we shall see about the cockroach. Cockroach is a small opening on the sides of its body. All the insects also will have in the same way. Even cockroach also will have like that one. Other insects also have similar. On the underside of the cockroach, in each segment, you can see in the pic how it is given. You can see if this is the head part of the cockroach. Here comes the tail part. Then here, you can see that it is having the segments like this. Okay, these segments are present here, and this system is called as trachea, and the small openings here is called as spiracles. The small openings here is called as spiracles. So are connected through respiratory tube network. These help the cockroach to breathe. These holes are called as spiracles, and the network of respiratory tubes called trachea take air from these spiracles, circulated throughout the body, collected back and sent to through again. Means it is taking air through the spiracles and it is sending out also through spiracles. When this process is going, it gives to all parts of the body. To know more about this process, you may observe a live cockroach. Don't kill the cockroach. If you are there enough, hold the cockroach and put it in a glass tumbler which is having holes. If you are keeping in the glass tumbler and if you close the lid, what will happen? It will die because it can't respire. So, which is having holes, you keep the cockroach in that one and close the lid and try to observe that one. If you are there enough, you can hold it and see that. By keeping it covered by a transparent bottle or glass, see the movement that occurs in its body. Okay? Then you will find the spiracles and the trachea. Got the point? Next one is of earthworm. Earthworm. What the earthworm will use? Earthworm uses its moist skin. What is the respiratory organ of earthworm? Earthworm uses its moist skin. So, earthworm breathes through their skin. It is thin and moist with minute holes. Through the skin, air spaces in and out. Air will go through that skin. The earthworm does breathe through its whole body surface. So, from the top to bottom, all the body will take the respiration. Name some other that they breathe. So you got it? How the earthworm will breathe? Earthworms uses its moist skin to breathe. Okay, next one, respiration in plants. Do plants respire? In nutrition in plants already we discussed. Plants respire through stomata. Only stomata? Lenticles. Only lenticles? Air space. So air spaces are present near roots. Lenticles are present near stem. Okay, stomata is present here, leaves. These all are the places where the plants respire. So, do plants respire in the way human do? In human beings, gases exchange with the surroundings takes place through nose and mouth. Then what is the nose of the plant? Stomata is called as the nose of the plant. So, part in plants that help in gaseous exchange. They are stomatas present on the surface of the leaf and lenticles present on the surface of the stem. Lenticles are present when we are coming to plant. Plants respire through stomata and through lenticles and through air spaces. Where these all are present? Stomata near the leaf, the lenticles through stem, and air spaces through roots. These all are the respiratory organs of the plant. Then when we are living all the gases, these plants will take all the gases. Okay, the impure air which is released from animals and human beings, total gases will be taken by the plant, and plant purifies and gives all the gases. Here the question is, will the plant respire all the gases? Means, yes, they will take all the gases what we released and they will give all the gases to us. got the point here? What is the nose of the plant? Stomata is the nose of the plant. Got this one? Now there is an experiment. Let us do an experiment to find out whether plants respire or not. That one we will discuss tomorrow. Thank you.